guys, Becky here with Design Bundles, and I'm super excited to have you join me today because we have a super awesome Cricut tutorial. We're working in Cricut Design Space, and we're showing you how to combine shapes and text. All right, guys, so here we are in Cricut Design Space, and I'm super excited. I love sharing software tutorials with you. I feel like a basic knowledge of designing can really go a long way, not only in setting up your own simple designs, but then also helping to customize and modify all the designs that you know and love from Design Bundles, of course. Plus, they have a lot of really great elements and fonts to work with, which is what we're talking about today, combining text and shapes together. So I'm going to start with something a little simple. Let's go to our uploads. I'm going to go to upload image, and I downloaded this arrows and wreaths. Let's see. I want the arrows. Oh, just kidding. I do want the arrows, but let's find which one I want first. It doesn't really matter, but you know, I do still want it to be cute. So let's go simple. Let's just still stick with the first arrow. So under the SVG, we'll choose number one. And I'm gonna go to upload to bring that into my little library here and insert it into my designing area. Now, the next thing that we're going to do is add some text. And so with text, you need to go ahead and think about your fonts. Yay, I love fonts. So super, super excited about that. Let's open a new text box and we will say, love, all love. And I'm going to use one of my new favorite fonts. It's called Nashville, and of course it's from my Plus membership. And let's just get this guy in here. So what I want to do is be able to break up this arrow and then insert love into the middle and kind of make it look like, you know, part of the same image. Does that make sense? All right. So I'm going to just do a box real quick, and then I'm going to, well, looks like I need to maybe, let's weld this together. There, that's what we need. Now I'm going to select these two, because remember, you can't do any slicing when it's more than one shape. So now I'm going to slice, and then I'll delete out the parts that I don't need, because my whole plan, that's what I needed. That was my entire plan right there. So now I can bring love in. There we go. So then I can select both of these and weld them together. All right. So that is the very basics of it, is you want to slice out an area and then be able to insert your text. Now let's talk about maybe making this look a little bit more natural. So I'm going to undo and separate those, and I'm going to copy and paste. I just use Control C and Control V, but then I can open my contour. And I'm just going to hide one of those. And that gives me the ability to work with each piece independently. There we go. Now I can actually make that look like part of the E. And I think what I'm going to do, I just held down my shift key because I do still want to size them together. I think I want to make them a little thinner. Okay, so now let's weld them together. Oh, isn't it cute? Love it. So really simple, really easy. Let's talk about something a tad more complex. We're just going to move this one off to the side. And let's bring in just one of our standard heart shapes. And we're going to work with, dun dun dun, the offset tool. So let's let the offset kick in. And let's do maybe like 0.15. Let's see what that looks like. Okay, that is better. So I'm going to select these two and slice. Obviously, slice plays a big role here. This is the one that I want, so I can separate it out. All I wanted was that outline, and the rest of these I can delete. So now I'm going to create some more text. You know what? Let's do love again. All right. So what I want to do is enlarge this, and I can use my rotate and rotate this. And what I want to do, see where the E curves? And I want to turn that into part of my text. Okay. So it'll look like love is part of the heart and it all blends together. But what we're going to do once again is copy and paste. And then we're going to select these two and slice. Now, once the slice, we're still going to use the contour, but for a slightly different reason. We need to get rid of love. And there we go. That's what I wanted. And get rid of the slice results there. Okay. But what I need to do is go to contour. And we're going to go to hide all. And just make sure that this piece here is selected. All we want is this outline. There we go. And see how it gets rid of all that stuff in the middle? So now we're actually going to make love just a tad bigger. That way it'll overlap these areas that were just subtracted out. So I can select this and now weld it together. So with a basic shape and some text, and then a shape that I imported and some text, we made two fairly unique designs in the matter of, 5 minutes? So really simple, really easy. And you don't have to stop at basic words like love. You know, I just, obviously that's how I'm feeling today. But you can do this with names and add customization. I mean, there's really a whole wide range of things that you can do, which is why I always stress just at least knowing the basics of designing. That way you can add those special touches to the files and designs and projects that you're working with. But for today, guys, I mean, that really is how simple and easy it is to combine text with shapes. So I'm going to wrap it up for now.
So guys, how did you feel about learning more about combining shapes and text in Cricut Design Space? Now, of course, there is a lot of potential there. There's so much that you can do and files that you can personalize to really give your projects that extra twist. Now, of course, if you have any questions or comments, definitely make sure you leave those down below. I do absolutely love hearing from you guys. If you learned something, make sure you give the video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and I really just appreciate all the support that you show for us here so that we can keep bringing you more videos in the future. So I'm going to wrap it up for today, guys, but thanks again for stopping by, and we'll see you again next time.